McGinley has the puck behind the net. He works into the blue line, left side. Ferentz over to the right point to Warner. He let the shot go, deflected wide. Off the glass in left corner to Aginla. Aginla to the left circle. Passing to Yell. A shot. Save made by Yell. Aginla's rebound. Another shot. A score! The Flames win it! Yeah, baby! Overtime 3-2. Flames gaining the win as Martin Jelinek knocks it in on the rebound. Oh, a wild Flames celebration as they score on the power play.
Now it's the Flames' turn to race ahead. Kovacu on right wing to center. Hatcher belts him off the puck, but Leopold carries on.
Shooting the puck into the Detroit zone. It goes around the end boards with a minute to go in the first overtime period. The puck's in the left corner of the Red Wing zone. The Flames have it. Conroy goes behind the net. He's wrapped up by Lang. The puck into the left corner for Aginla. Aginla to the left circle. Aginla shot. Joseph save. Rebound. He scores! Yeah, baby! Yeah, baby! Martin Jelinek scores! The Flames win it! 1-0! Yeah, baby!
Conference final.
The veteran does it again. Marty Jelinek just perched himself at the side of the net. Conroy and Aginla doing all the work. The puck eventually coming to Jelinek. Jelinek throw it in the net, and now the Flames are moving on.
The Flames beat the best team in the National Hockey League during the regular season, the Detroit Red Wings. 4-2. Clinching it in overtime tonight. Here's the announcement on the winning goal.
Game 6, scored by number 23, Martin Jelinek! Assistant number 22, Craig Conroy! And the number 12, Jerome Aginla!
Kemper Carpet time of the winning goal. Martin Jelinek, for the first or the second time in this playoff year, ends a series with an overtime goal. Saddle Dome, 19,289. Flames moving to the hack, racing that Jelinek shot. Yours! Martin Jelinek! It's 2-0!
Well, what a play by the veteran Marty Jelinek, coming in off the left side right from the faceoff, faking the shot, taking a little bit off it. That forced the Nabokov to go down, opening his legs. Jelinek saw that spot, putting it through the legs, putting the Flames up 2-0 in this hockey game.
Against Daffoos. Face off in the Calgary zone. 15 seconds left. Nail biting time. Conroy wins the draw. Into the corner to Regier. He's checked in against the boards. Battle for the puck continues in behind the flame. Koriluk has it. Koriluk with 6 seconds left. Passing in front. The pass doesn't work. It goes down the ice. Just to the empty net. A score! You can put it in the wind column. The Flames are Western Conference champions. Yeah, baby!
They're going to count that goal, but who really gives a care? What an effort by this Flames hockey team. Give San Jose credit. They battled hard in this third period, trying to tie the game, but the Flames team would not be denied, as you said, going to the Stanley Cup final.
And the Flames are celebrating on the ice as their fans are celebrating in the stands and all over Calgary. A tremendous celebration going on as for the third time in their history. the Flames will play for the Stanley Cup. They will face off against either the Tampa Bay Lightning or the Philadelphia Flyers beginning next Tuesday in either Philadelphia or Tampa, with Tampa leading the series 3-2. And as they shake hands here at center ice, the table is being set for the presentation of the Clarence Campbell Bowl to the winners of the Western Conference, the Calgary Flames. And now the congratulatory handshakes taking place at center ice. Flame players who were not playing tonight are all out of the ice now with baseball caps on, depicting their championship, the Western Conference title. And those, of course, will be popular in the Calgary area. And the crowd continuing to stand and cheer and sing as the Flames, with their theme song, The Ring of Fire, ring in the San Jose Sharks, just like they ran in the Vancouver Canucks and the Detroit Red Wings to get to the final. And in a moment, we'll have the presentation, and they're playing the song that is the Flames theme song.